Hi, I'm Mario Haro, and in this video, I want to show you how to connect your piano to your iPad using Bluetooth wireless MIDI technology. In order to do this, you need a Bluetooth wireless MIDI interface. I'm going to first demonstrate using the Yamaha MD-BT01 wireless Bluetooth MIDI adapter. And what I like about this particular adapter, it has the 5 pins, just like you see on standard MIDI cables, and it will work with any piano that has that there. Also has these arrows that will tell you where to, in which MIDI in and out port that you'll plug the particular receptacles to. So here on my Yamaha Disklavier, I have MIDI in and out ports. I'm going to take one of the end that has the arrow pointing towards it and plug it into the MIDI in. And then I'll take the one that has the arrow pointing out and plug that into the MIDI out port. Oops, excuse me. Like so here. And there's a nice little red LED that will show that it will be its feeding power into the Bluetooth MIDI interface. The next step in the process is to pair your iPad with your Bluetooth MIDI device. Now, it's not how you traditionally do it in with other devices such as like Bluetooth headphones or Bluetooth foot pedals. Normally when you do that, you go into settings here and then you go into Bluetooth. Make sure, of course, Bluetooth is on. And of course, when you're connecting your other devices, normally you can pair them over here, but you won't see the Yamaha Bluetooth MIDI device show up on there. What you need is an application that supports Bluetooth MIDI technology. And one of my favorite apps is SuperScore, right down here. And if we go into that, I'm going to go into the gear, the settings. And you'll notice under MIDI setup here, and then I'm gonna show add a Bluetooth MIDI device. So you see where it says tap the plus button, and then there you'll see a list of Bluetooth MIDI devices that I've previously connected to my iPad. And there you see the MD-BT01 is actually highlighted and it shows that it's not connected. I just tap on that one time and it will say that it's connected now. So in the MIDI setup, all I have to do is select the MD-BT01 Bluetooth for my MIDI input device. And I could also select it as my MD-BT01 Bluetooth for my MIDI output device. I'm going done here. Here I have a little short Tchaikovsky piece, Morning Prayer. And if I go ahead and click play, this is what happens. The neat things I love about this wireless technology on the iPad is now you can just download performances off of the internet here. Of course, they have to be in a MIDI file format here. And one website that you might be interested in is the Yamaha Disklavier Education Network at yamahaden.com. There's a signature MIDI collection that contains a lot of classical music that's been captured in the MIDI format here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that signature MIDI collection. It's going to take me to all these different lists of composers here. Let's say I want to listen to some Chopin. I can just tap on Chopin here. And let's say I want to listen to his etudes. And let's listen to the etude in E major, opus 10, number 3. There's a performance by Mei Ting Sun from the 2002 International Piano E Competition. I'm just going to download the standard MIDI file. I'm just going to tap on this standard MIDI file link here. It's going to ask me here what application would I like to open it in. Now you can't open it up in SuperScore, but you can open it in other MIDI applications, and I have another application called Home Concert Extreme that I'd like to use to play all my MIDI files on my piano here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Open in Home Concert, and it's going to open up Home Concert Extreme. And here we have the MIDI file for Mei Ting Sun's performance of the Chopin Etude. Now the notation will look really messed up here because it's a capture of his raw performance here. But what I love is the on-screen keyboard, which will display all the keys that he's played and even captures all his pedaling that goes through. So check it out here when I tap on play. What's great is this wireless connection between the iPad and your piano works both ways here. So not only can you send MIDI data from the iPad to the piano, but also anything that I play on the piano notes gets recreated in the on the iPad as well here. So this is great for students here that would like to play along with MIDI files like this one by Christopher Norton here. Now, not all pianos have MIDI in and out ports on them. For example, the piano behind me is a Yamaha Portable Grand DGX digital piano, and it has no MIDI in and out ports, but it has a direct USB to host port, which you can connect to other devices if you want to connect through it through MIDI here. So the MD-BT01 that I showed earlier won't work with this particular model. Fortunately, there are other wireless MIDI adapters, and this is another one by Yamaha, and this is the UD-BT01, and it works just well with pianos that don't have the MIDI in and out ports, but just have USB to host, and I'll show you how to make that happen. Now, in addition to the wireless MIDI adapter, you're also, for this particular setup, you're also going to need one of these USB power adapters. Unfortunately, it didn't come with one here, so you'll have to have one on your own. But most owners of iPads already have one handy because it usually comes with their mobile devices. And the reason why they do that is because for the USB host, direct to host port, it doesn't provide enough power in order to support the MIDI data transfer between the device and the digital piano, so you'll need to have external power connected to it. And then on the other end, you'll also have to have a USB cable, USB A to B cable. These are just like your standard printer cables, the ones that have a kind of a square side, and then also the more rectangular receptacle. This particular cable is readily available. You'll find it on most standard printers or scanners that connect to your computer through USB. And you just plug in this end into the other end of the wireless MIDI adapter, like so, and then you're ready to go. On your piano, find the USB to host port, and then take the squarish end of your USB A to B cable and plug that into the piano, just like that. Take the other end of the USB cable that has both the wireless MIDI adapter and your power adapter and plug that into a power source, like so. You should see those red and light and green lights flashing to show that it's supplying power now to the wireless MIDI adapter. It's not as eloquent a solution as the other wireless MIDI adapters because you have to plug it into power, but seeing as you're probably going to be needing power to plug in your digital piano, you're probably going to be close enough to a source to make this particular way happen, and you at least won't have to connect your iPad directly to the piano. So if I want to pair my iPad now to the wireless MIDI adapter connected to the DGX piano, I do follow the same process. I open up an application like SuperScore, I go into the MIDI settings, and then I go into add a Bluetooth device. And now instead of the MD-BT01, now I'll find the UD-BT01, and I'll tap on that once, and then it will say that it's connected now. You want to make sure that both the MIDI input device is selected as the UD-BT01, so it will recognize you're playing. And then the MIDI output device, if the iPad is sending out MIDI data to the piano, then it will also make that connection as well. I've got that all set up, and I can go on ahead and click Done. Now I have this piece, Just Strut Along by Martha Mir, that I can have it set to play along with me. And actually, the sound's not coming from the iPad. The iPad is sending the MIDI data from the file on the iPad to the piano, and it's activating all the general MIDI sounds on it here. So hope you enjoy this one here. I hope you found that video helpful as far as connecting your iPad to your piano using wireless Bluetooth MIDI technology. If you have any questions, you can leave it in the comments on this video, or you could also reach out to me through various social media platforms here. So that's all for now, and keep on practicing. Bye.